What's up, it's Ed, and welcome back to another lesson on guitar. This time the song is Did My Time by the band Korn, and it's on the Take a Look in the Mirror album. It's the sixth track. Before diving into the lesson, I want to talk about the gear you need to have in order to play the song correctly. So first of all, I want to talk about the guitar. You need to have a 7-string guitar in order to perform the song, because Korn uses a 7-string guitar and they are tuned a whole step down. All the strings are a whole step down tuned. So it's like A, D, G, C, F, A, D. Right now I'm tuned in drop A. So for the last string, I've tuned a whole step down. So it's A, E, A, D, G, B, E. Okay, then I'm using my cabinet, my Marshall DSL-15H head, and I'm using the overdrive pedal, the Eddie Van Halen, the 5150. And for some effects, I recommend to use like a chorus effect or a detune effect. I'm using my whammy pedal. The shallow effect gives it a little detune effect that in some parts the sound is pretty similar. The sound you get with this effect is pretty similar to the original. Then I want to talk about that Korn has two guitarists, James Shaffer and Brian Welch. So on this lesson we want to see for each of the two guitarists what they are doing on the whole song. Sometimes they are doing the same thing, and sometimes one is doing a thing and the other one is doing another thing. So let's start on the lesson. As you can see, I've imported two tracks this time. The first one is the album track, and the second one is the live version on Live and Rare album. I made it like this because I know on live it's another thing than on the studio. So this time we're gonna see the live version, because it's exactly what they're playing live. So let's dive into the song. I think the song is on D minor, and on the first part of the intro, I think Monkey, it's playing like which is 3rd fret, 3rd string, and 5th fret, 3rd string, and it's C, D. Then the other part, it's which is 3rd fret, 1st string, and 6th fret, 1st string, which is C and D sharp. Then on the intro is switching between these two parts, so let's play along with it. Then we got the theme part, that is the chorus 2, that it's like which is 5th fret 3rd string, which is D, 5th fret 2nd string, which is A, 8th fret 1st string, which is F, 3rd fret 1st string, which is C, and 7th fret 1st string, which is E. So the part of the theme is still the same, so let's play along with it. If you want, I recommend a thick pick with the smooth sides, so you can play these up and down strokes easier. Then we got the verse part, which is almost the same thing as the intro, almost the same notes, C, D, and C, D sharp, 3rd fret 1st string, 5th fret 1st string, and 6th fret first string. On this part, you need to pay attention on how to mute the strings, because it's very subtle and it's very precise. So let's play along with the bass. Then we got another pre-chorus, then the chorus, which is all the same riff over and over again. But on this part, I think that's Head is playing another thing. So let's play along, and then we're gonna talk about the layer part below the part, the main part. So on this part, as I said before, I think that Head is playing another thing, so I'm gonna switch my effect on. So now I have the whammy pedal switched on the shallow mode, and the pedal is all the way down. The part is... which is on the 5th string, 7th fret, 9th fret, 10th fret, and 12th fret, which is D, E, F, G. Which is D, E, F, G. So this part is played 4 times above the monkey part. Then we got the verse again. I'm gonna switch off my whammy pedal, hold on. Then, as I was saying, we got the verse again, the second verse, which is the same thing as the verse before, so let's play along with it. Then we got the pre-chorus again and the chorus. Then we're gonna play the Head part again. Then when we play the chorus, all the part, we're gonna hold the last note, the G, the 12th fret. My guitar doesn't have that much sustain, so whatever. Fade away. But whatever, we got the point. Then we got the bridge, which is a clean part. I'm gonna switch off my whammy pedal and the overdrive pedal. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. The part is... which is 3rd fret, 1st string, always C. Then we got, which is 6th fret and 5th fret of the 3rd string, which is D sharp and D. Then we got 6th fret of the 2nd string, which is A sharp. The first 3 time is playing the same thing, then the 4th time is playing the A sharp octave above. Should be like that, but if you want, you can play it here. this thing of the octave above, it's played only for the first part, which is only the one guitar that is playing. Then the other parts are always the same thing without the octave above. Always this riff. Head in this part is playing some ghostly notes. He's using the overdrive pedal and always the chorus pedal or the shallow pedal or the detune pedal. So let's play along with this main part, then we're gonna see what's below the main riff. Okay, then this is the main part, then we're gonna see what's below the part. I'm gonna switch on again my overdrive pedal and the whammy pedal. So on this part, head is doing not that much, is doing some notes here and there to, you know, get more mystic sound. He's playing basically on the 7th string, he's playing 19th fret, 20th fret, and on the string above, the 6th string, he's playing the 20th fret and the 21st fret, which is B, C, and G, G sharp. And on the last part, just before the breakdown, the two notes are, which is 12th fret, 10th fret of the 5th string, and is G and F. Then we have the first breakdown. I'm gonna switch off my whammy pedal. Hold on again. If you're wondering why I kept my pedal over there, is because I don't have long wires. So sorry, my apologies. So on this part, I think they're using another distortion pedal, even with the overdrive. So because the sound is very thick, very powerful and very distorted. Okay, so the part goes on the 3rd fret of the 1st string, 4th fret of the 1st string, and the 1st fret of the 1st string. What I'm hearing, it's like... Then we got the second breakdown, which is only instrumental, and basically is the same thing as the verse, but on the 1st fret of the 1st string and the 3rd fret of the 1st string. Then 4th fret of the 1st string and 1st fret of the 1st string. Then we have the chorus again, which is the same thing as the chorus before. There's a little difference on the head part, so I'm gonna switch on my whammy pedal again. Basically, it's holding another note at the last part of the chorus.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's holding the part for the last four bars. Gonna switch off the whammy pedal again. And then we have the outro part, which is the same thing as the verse. So this was the lesson of how to play Did My Time by Korn. Hope you enjoyed the cover. If you want, you can download the tabs down here. There's a PDF file and a Guitar Pro 5 file. If you don't have Guitar Pro as a program to run the tab, you can use Tax Guitar, which is an open source program by Linux. If you have Windows, there's no problem. You can use it even on Windows. So you can play the song along with the tempo, which is 186 beats per minute. Thanks again for passing by. Please leave a like and a comment down below if you enjoyed the video. If you have any suggestions about a song you want me to make the lesson about, leave it on the comment down below and I'll see what I can do. If you're new here, please consider to subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so you get all the notification about the new videos I will post that will be out each 2 weeks. And by doing so, you're helping me making more content like this in the future and keep uploading videos. Take a look to my channel too. I'm doing a lot of different stuff like metal covers of songs that aren't metal, normal covers with the availability of tabs, always free downloadable, and lessons like this. I just made a few videos so far. If you already subscribed, a big thank you. You're a beast. As always, I will see you in the next video. Peace!